Hi everyone, welcome to Standard Share. So this video is all about the camera-lens relationship. So this will be shared only for members, and kindly do watch this video to understand what has actually happened today. So I've uploaded a video on Nifty post-market analysis. Do watch that to understand with price action as well as camera-lens relationship. Now in this video, I'll cover three topics. One is like why it was a trending day. Second one is like what is tomorrow's relationship and what we can expect. And third is like extreme reversal setup, how to understand that. Clear? So moving on to this video further. So we guys know it is a lower value relationship. And even the if you see the distance between the Camarella H3 and L3 is also wide only. So obviously we can expect a normal day, not a trending day. But this day, today, it was a good trending day. Why that has happened is like very, very simple reason. This trending day happened because the bias got rejected. Clear? When there is a good bias, like bearish bias or bullish bias, and if suppose the trend is getting reversal. See, for example, if you see, it is a bearish bias, moderately bearish bias. So bias is continuously like 3-4 days, it was like bearish bias only. But then the market trend suddenly changed with the gap up and started taking support at the previous day high and started moving up. So this tells that the bias is rejected. Whenever a bias is rejected, the market can go for a trending nature. Clear? This is said in the Secret of Pivot Boss book. Kindly read that book once or check the videos again. You guys will be able to understand whether this has been said in the Secret of Pivot Boss book or not by Franco Chowa. Clear? So this is the secret behind today's trending nature. Everyone will have a doubt. See, obviously the H3 and L3 is looking like this. Previous day H3 and L3, the distance is also big. So that means the today will not be a trending day. But obviously it went for a trending day. How this can happen? Very simple. This has happened because whenever a bias is getting rejected, the trend changes. So that day will be a trending day. Clear? Now let's move on to the content of tomorrow's pivots. Okay, so this is the tomorrow's pivot. So today's pivot was over here and tomorrow's pivot was over here. So what is this bias is called? Okay, so kindly comment in the comment section so that I can understand that you guys are also in the flow. Okay, so this bias is called as the two-day relationship, higher value relationship. Clear? So the bias is bullish, very bullish, not moderately bullish, very bullish. So what can we expect? Clear? What can we expect? I'll tell you guys. So let's hide this here. So what will happen is like, so if the candle is opening with a gap down or opening below L3, so any pullback towards L3 is going to be a shorting opportunity. Clear? One scenario is covered. Second scenario, if suppose the candle is opening between H3 and L3, so any pullback towards L3 is going to be a buying opportunity. Clear? And if suppose the candle is opening above H3, then any pullback towards H3 is going to be a buying opportunity. Clear? Very, very simple and very, very neat, I have told. So what is expected is like a higher value relationship. So the bias will be bullish. The bias is bullish, but opening candle will decide whether the bias is going to be accepted or rejected. Okay, so I have told where the candles can open and what can happen also. So kindly check for the price action and decide what will happen next. Clear? So now moving on to this video. Now moving on to this video of extreme reversal setup. Clear? So let me clear this. Extreme reversal setup example ready. So this came in my radar. So this is the extreme reversal setup example. So what is the criteria for extreme reversal setup? I have already made a video on that. Do watch that video to understand what is the extreme reversal setup. I've also pasted some of the few screenshots in the Telegram channel of explaining what is extreme reversal setup. Kindly watch that content as well to understand what is an extreme reversal setup. So the first criteria for an extreme reversal setup is like the first candle or any candle which should be a extreme candle. So this candle is an extreme candle. Why it is an extreme candle? So such a big candle. And what was said in the Pivot Boss book is like the average of few candles should be okay. So this is the average of few candles. So if you see the average body size or the average total size of the candle and the extreme size candle should be at least more than 2 to 3 times. So that tells that this candle is an extreme candle. Obviously, we can say that these candles average is a twice or thrice of this, like this candles compare. If you see, this is twice and thrice of these candles. Clear? So first candle, first condition satisfied. Second, so if it is a red bar, the lower bottom that needs to be a wick, and it should show some rejection. Yes, rejection seen. Second criteria satisfied. Third criteria. The next candle should be a opposite color candle. So this is a red candle and this is a green candle. Opposite criteria also satisfied. Now I'm telling you a secret criteria. Clear? Okay. So where does the candle open? The candle open between H3 and L3. So L3 is going to be a reversal layer. So obviously we can expect some reversal, and this is also looks like extreme reversal setup, and that is how the reversal started happening and went till the top of the candle, which means day high of the candle. Clear? Very, very simple. Three criterias which is already told in Pivot Boss book, and this fourth one I have analyzed and I have just noticed that. So that is what has happened today. Clear? Got it? So let's take another example, Airtel. Okay, so this is also a bearish candle and extreme candle. Average candle's body is like comparing that. It is 2 to 3 times bigger and the wick is not much there. So second criteria not satisfied, and third criteria opposite candle satisfied. But what has happened is like candles has opened below L3 and L4. So any pullback towards L3 and L4 is going to be a shorting opportunity, and that is why happened. So you should not take this trade, because second criteria itself failed. There is no bottom wick, so that itself failed. So you have to be very cautious and just check all the criteria are passed, then only you should take. Otherwise you should not take this particular stock or particular setup. Clear? I hope I have made something clear. I'll also try to make some other setups on wick reversal setup, camera law, like combining both, and then I'll also share some secrets on that. So we'll try to share at least maximum one extreme reversal setup and do some analysis on that. So you guys also try to write some codes and understand what is extreme reversal setup and all those things. So that will help you guys to understand the market using camera. So if you feel the content is good, kindly give a like. And I think if you can't share it, because if you share also, others cannot see, because they'll not be in a part of the membership plan. So I would request each and everyone to give the feedback so that I can post that feedback in the YouTube channel or in the Telegram channel, so that others can get interested and start watching the Camera Law videos. So thanks for watching. Bye-bye.